What's up, guys? It's your man, G-Star Games here, bringing you a new series of Need for Speed Most Wanted. This is one of my favorites, Need for Speed. Obviously going from Underground and Underground 2 to then Most Wanted. You know, there's many hours spent on it when I was a youngin. Today we are going to be going back through it. Today we are just doing the intro and getting to Blacklist member number 15, who is Sunny, if I believe. Yeah, I think it's Sunny. And as we're just watching these intro videos, you know, I was mesmerized as a kid, you know, the graphics on this game, you know, coming out for PS2 and original Xbox, I think it did anyway. And yeah, the graphics was amazing, you know, back in them days. And even in-game gameplay was amazing, you know. Cause I think this was like the first one in real daylight, you know, after like Underground and Underground 2. It was like in the daylight, and it's like, wow. But times have changed from then. And there we go, Lieutenant Cross. No, not Lieutenant Cross, Sergeant Cross. Cross, what am I on about? And here we go, Need for Speed Most Wanted. Into the credits. Press start to begin. Playing on the good old Xbox 360, of course. With the HD edition. You gotta love the Xbox 360, man. And there we go, entering the name G-Star, as always. Because we are G-Star Games. Come on, hit the R. There we go, good lad. Do you want to save the alias? Yes, I do. Moo-ha-ha-ha. And yeah, we've got the main menu. Straight into career mode. Let's get on it. Good old controls. And here we go up against Razor. The dirty bastard, what he is. Present day challenging Blacklist rival number 15. The cheating one. Because he is a cheating bastard. How's your car doing? You know, because you fucking messed with it, you little Chinese prick. And there's a lovely Mia. Boy crush on her when I was a young man, I tell thee. She was tip top amazing. And there's that little prick. Hey man, I'm gonna take your car, then I'm gonna take your girl. Shut up, Muppet. But yeah. Smirk, little grin on his fucking shit Mustang. And here we have European power. And there we go. Little cutscene before we get into it, as always. And again, you know, the graphics for this, you know, just is it in the game, you know, you're watching this car chase with the police and you and Razor, and you're just thinking, wow. You know, and as they go waltzing through the city, you know, and the police are chasing them, it's, you know, it's unbelievable for its time, you know. I think this game even compares with the new Need for Speed, you know. It is one of the old greats. And the thing about the newest Need for Speed, you know, they said, oh, they're going back to the underground route and blah de blah. But it wasn't. It was just a underground with fucking expensive cars. You know, if I want to do an underground tuning game, I don't want to be doing it with Porsches or Lamborghinis or Ferraris, you know. I want to do it with fucking Skylines and Mazdas and, you know, the proper tuner cars, you know, the Imprezas, the Evos. As I hit the barrier there, whoopsies. But again, you can't fucking win this race, can you? Because it's fucking just the intro. But... And yeah, she comes on the radio. Your car's broken, man. You gotta end the race soon. And there we go. We crashed. But hey ho, what shall be, shall be. 6 days ago, entering Rockport City. As you get a nice little panoramic shot of the city there. And we drive our M3 into town. You know, I've said on a previous video as well that I do stutter a little bit and I do swear a little bit. So that's why I might get some of my words mumbled up, you know. So, yeah. Ooh, who's this chick, eh? She's kind of fine. Driving a little Mazda RX-7. Little jump there. As we go racing through past the police car. But what your guys' memories of playing this game, you know? And here comes Sergeant Cross. The tough motherfucker. Driving his Corvette. Trying to be all big man. Yo, it's the police. Damn, this is a nice ride. This is just for show. But he can fucking do one. Oi, oi. Well, his little chick there as well. Fucking slap her. Get out. But that's what you gonna do, eh? If you're gonna arrest me, punk. Oh, let's get out the fucking way. Again, I'll fucking slap her all over. Not that I'm condoning hitting women, like, but you know, sometimes a bitch just needs a punch. No, but I'm only joking. Never hit a woman. Never, ever, ever. Yeah, now he's telling me to get out the car. Get out the ride, punk. But, luckily for us, there's some other one causing trouble. So we get a free pass. Get out of jail free card. That's right, motherfucker. Get out my way. I need to go race. Now take your black ass and get in your car. Motherfucker has just keyed our car. Oh, look at the smirk grin on him. Ooh, he's really pissed me off now. Motherfucker. Now let's go. 4 days ago, cruising the streets. As you do. Ba-na-ba-na-ba. It's a motherfucking sleet OG Snoop Dogg. We'll come across a little yellow Supra. Well, that Jimmy Chan looking motherfucker. Old Ronnie. Don't know what he's laughing for. I'm gonna have the cunt. Here we go. Start your engines. I'm gonna try and get a perfect shift on this one. There we go. Perfect launch. And we are off. Off into the lead with a little NOS boost. And that's it, folks. It's game over. You know, even the most fucking average car racing driver, you know, you don't have to be a fucking brilliant player. As I just fucking missed a car there. But, yeah, like I said, you don't have to be a fucking amazing player to win the early races. You really don't. If you can't win these early races first time, then you just shouldn't be playing the game, really. Yeah, like I said, got in front first and that's it. I'm off. I'm off, skis. See you later, mate. Little bit of a Nosprey. Get over the hill. Coming up with some tycooners. Little, see if we get a handbrake turn. Try and do a bit of drifting. But no. Getting a little spray over the hill. Around the corners. But again, it's just straightforward, easy. You know, you don't have to be the best. It's just a case of fucking getting in front, and there you go. Final straight, around the last corner. There we go. £10,000. Well, 10,000 cash. Again, guys, if you want to play this game for gold time's sake, you know, try and beat me times. You know, if you can beat me times, let us know in the comment section. You know, we'll try and get a rivalry going. You know, I mean, like I said, they're not the quickest times. You know, it's just a little cruise. You don't have to race properly a day. It's just a little cruise. You know, and there we go, driving off in victory. Yeah, you lost, son. You lost, and he's getting his big buddy across, old Razor. Shit it, but he's good, man. He's awesome. Razor Callahan, the cheating motherfucker. with his little crew thinking he's solid. Ooh, and he has army, yeah. Like I said before, man, biggest boy crush. Fucking got him, man. Look at that little tank tube top. Tight little shorts and a nice little tube top. Oh, yes. Pervy side coming out. Yeah, that's to do with the big talk. We didn't care about the big talk, man, do we? We didn't. Trash talk don't mean nothing. Trash talk don't mean nothing. Let them get on with it. I'll just race cars and win, like I used to. But yeah, what's your guy's favourite Need for Speed? You know, is it the fucking early ones, you know, the Hot Pursuit and stuff like that? Or is it Underground 2 that brought him more mainstream? Or is it, like, say, Carbon or Most Wanted or Carbon? Or to like, the track day ones, you know, like, say, Shift 2, Pro Street? Or is it the newer ones? You know, Rivals, the newer remake of Most Wanted, which is good. I'll probably bring that to you after this one, like. So, what do you prefer, the newer ones? You know, fucking Hot Pursuit, Rivals, the new Need for Speed 2015, which, I mean, I think they try to throw big names at it, you know, like, say, fucking Kenny Block and the rest of them. But it's a good game, you know. But again, it's a Need for Speed title. It's just not up there, you know. And next is our next rival. I think I said it was Rio, wasn't it? Drive these little SLR. And again, we'll get off to the good start, and that's it, you know. Just cruising. Cruising, let's cruise, you know. Let's go do it. Uh-oh. We're in trouble. No, I'm only joking. You know, this voice... I've recorded this after I've done the game. So I'm watching the game, recording the audio as you're watching it. Because there was a problem where fucking Sony Vegas, which I used to edit. So I've got to re-record the audio, so a bit of a bummer, like, but it's got to be done, hasn't it? And again, just nice, straightforward, easy cruising, you know, dodging the 5-0, and that's it, you know. Once you get past it, you get past it. So let's just do it, you know, nice, easy little cruise. Just take us to victory. Because, I mean, in these games, once you race it, all you've got to do is get past the police and fucking they'll go after the car behind you, you know? So it's easy done. So now we shall just cruise to victory. And across the line for another 10,000 cash. Again, guys, look at the time and try and go beat it, you know? If you can go beat it, comment down below saying that you're beating it and what time you posted, and then I'll try and beat you back. As you do. And again, here we go into the next race. I think this is a 4-way race, isn't it? Yeah, 4-way race. And perfect launch, and we are off. Now, I actually fucked up on this one. Well, I didn't fuck up, but I only thought it was a sprint race. I didn't realize it was a circuit. So at the end of the race, I just proper spray, you know, spray on my nose across the line thinking I've won, and then realise that it's a circuit race, I've got to keep going. But, like I said, easy done. Easy done. Taking a bit of the city with us, you know, you got to destroy those lampposts. We'll try and get somewhere across it. Oh, I think it's the next one, I'll get somewhere. But this bit that is coming up now, you know, as you go through the little parkway, it's either hit or miss. If you're going full speed, you either get through or you don't. because you come around this bend here, and then you're doing, and you're up and over the jump, and right about here, this is where I spray across the line thinking I've won. There goes spray, and oh shit, it's a 2 fucking lap race. But yeah, that park bit, you either get nailed or you nail it, you know, because you come round the bend full speed, you hit the ramp, and you either into the wall or you luckily you're through. And I mean, I get through both times. I don't know if you'll call that skill or if it's just pure luck, but I'm gonna go with skill. Yes sirree. I think it's this jump here we try to get the air as we come round. Although saying that, we just used a little bit of spray there, so there we go, bit of spray, get a bit of air, hit the wall as we come through, and then as you see I'm fucking miles ahead. I should have took an easy run this bend just to run the park, but I thought fuck it. As you come round the bend, you hit the ramp, and it's either there, that you either fucking nail the wall or not. And I get through and I spray again, across the line, this time for the win. And there she say, our winning time and 10,000 cash. Can you beat that time? Go have a try. Now again, I'm gonna try and get interactive, you know, with you guys, you know, if I post the time, you know. Feel free to go challenge it and go beat it and let us know, and maybe we can set up some custom races with you guys, you know. So I'm going to say card games are one of my favourite, you know, I am good at them. I don't tend to go 100% most of the time when you can just cruise and easily win, you know. And this is where we challenge Razor for the second time. Present day challenge and blacklist rival number 15, Razor Callahan. Now the audio might be a bit synced on the game here because I fucking, oh no, I must have cut that bit out. And here we go. Got a bit of a shit start, you know, try to spray into the lead. This one's a bit more tougher, but again, it's not that hard. If you're decent enough at the game, you should easily do it, you know. You shouldn't have to restart the race and whatnot. So, again, just cruising. Easy cruising, more or less. It's not that hard. None of this game's pretty hard, you know, apart from the fucking, the bounty rifles, you know. I was saying that as I just get overtook there. But he had a popo. Like I said, none of this game's pretty hard unless you get until the police bounty ones. That, you know, it's later on in the game, which you need to get a progress. Some of them can be a bit tricky, but again, they're not that hard. This should be easy enough for you guys, you know. And then we'll go around the outside. Easy peasy, lovely dribbly. Try and get in front of the police so they focus the attention on the Razor. A little drift around the corner. And then there we go. Hip hop to it. More police up ahead. Just give him a nice little smack. Here we go. More or less back to the start of the race. Well, the original start of the race. Because this is where he started. Of course, as you've just seen. Around here. Luckily, I didn't hit the barrier this time. Through the checkpoint. And then down around the corner. And this is where Mia gets onto us. Hey man, you left some slicker oil at the start of the race, you gotta end it quick. Right, yeah, okay, I'm going. And then you come round, yeah, and then your car fucks. Cluck, as I was miles in front, I would have had him as well. I really would have had him, but tough shit, eh? The cheating motherfucker. That's another thing I hate with guys, you know, not just on car games and specifically, you know, fucking any other kind of game, you know, where people try to use in-game mechanics, you know, to try and fucking hinder the result and stuff, and it's just like, what's the point of fucking playing? FIFA's a good example of that. You know, people use bronze benches and the fucking resort of handicapping, you know, pausing the game on corners, bringing players across and just shit like that to try and fucking hand, you know, sort of gain an advantage in the game. Why? What's the fucking point of playing if you're going to try and cheat? You know what I mean? Does my fucking head in. You know, why play a game? I try to exploit it, you know, get an advantage. You know, if you're not good enough, don't fucking play the game. But that's just fucking me, innit? And the police turn up and all them fuck off. Yeah, Sergeant Cross. Prick came my car. You're under arrest now, son. Where's your car? Aye. Even then, he's too fucking soft to arrest us. He's got to get his little girlfriend to fucking do it. And then he smiles out all pretty. Aye. You're not by smiling at the end, mate, when I fucking outrun you. And there we go, sometime later. Later, later, later. Wee. Sorry for the singing. I think I'm good, but I'm really not. And there's our friend Mia. The hottie with a totty. Little RX-7. That's gotta be one of the favourite cars for any game, you know, and fucking either be Need for Speed or Forza or Gran Turismo. It's gotta be an RX-7. And the motherfucker's using our car to get out the blacklist. Fucking asshole. Wait till I get him. And then yeah, we'll go guys picking the cars. What car did you guys pick when you first played the game? Yeah? Out of the three, was it a Cobalt, Fiat Punto, and I can't say what the other one is. See, I go to try to buy the Golf, but I realise I haven't got enough money. So second choice is the Punto. I'm actually going to plan to stick with the Punto for a fair while, you know. Because it's actually not a bad little car. Until you get like the top 5, top 6 of the blacklist. You can do it quite easily. Quite easily. And as Mia sends a text saying, hey, I meet you at my place, honey. I don't know why, what I was doing here. But I resume free road mode, and here we go. I'm actually playing one hand. Because I think I got a phone call, or I got a text message. So just whizzing through on one hand, you know. That's why the driving's a bit erratic. Crashing into everything and a doink. I think I crashed into the barrier here, don't I? Yeah, there we go. Doink, da doink, da doink. Now let's go to the beach. Where we go? Oh, we're going to the garage, aren't we? Oh, we're going to the safe house. Yeah, we're going to the safe house. Gotta get to the safe house. Get away. Bam, 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 bam. And here we go, arrived. Engage mechanic. What was your guys' favourite car while playing Need for Speed? You know, did you used to keep the cars, the pink slips? Or did you used to keep your own car all the way through? Because, I mean, that's what we're going to try to do. We're going to try to get all the pink slips, but obviously we might not be able to. But we shall try. We shall wait and see. And there's a blacklist. B... And that's where we plan to get, right at the top, and beat that little prick off it. Blacklist, rival number 15. Sonny. Wants to drive the Golf GTI. But is he beatable? Of course he is. He's only Blacklist number 15. This year's Sonny. He's dumped a whole lot of cash in his car. That ride is work, so don't be fooled. It's a rocket. He does anything he can to get hold of a part before they hit the streets. So he thinks he's a bit of a boy racer, eh? But he might be number 15, but he won't be for long. Because we plan to take him down. Take him down to Chinatown. So yeah. So do you guys think we'll be able to do it? I mean, it's pretty obvious we will, you know, since he's Blacklist number 15. It's pretty easy, but you never know. I think I'm going to leave that episode here, guys. Next episode, we shall get on beating Sonny, Blacklist rival number 15. So yeah, always remember, guys, please subscribe if you're new around here. And if you could, please leave a like on the video. Let's try to get 10 likes on this one. And again, see you all next time. That's all, folks.